Hello, everyone. Welcome to my channel. This video is extremely prevalent to you because you're in the pandemic, and if you're not in it now, you were in it because I'm assuming you're not an infant. So thank you for watching this show, this channel, this episode, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to explain a few things about stress and then 5 easy tips to reduce your stress. So thank you for watching in advance. Stick around till the end and let's get started. So allostatic load is a term that I'm super interested in. I learned about it from a girl named Robin Noling, and her Instagram is The Real Life RD. She's also a blogger, and her blog name is therealliferd.com. She has a whole blog post on allostatic load. That's where I'm getting a lot of my information from. So here is the credit. It all goes to her. I'll link it in the description, but let me explain to you what I've understood from her about allostatic load. So allostatic load is the cumulative wear and tear that we put on our bodies when we are exposed to repeated stress. Picture two types of stress. There's good stress and bad stress, or productive stress and unproductive stress. Good stress is and can be fun. Like maybe you just got a new job. Maybe you're getting married. Maybe you just moved. Maybe you just had a baby. Maybe you're pregnant, blah, blah, blah. Good stuff. Maybe you just started training for a triathlon and you're having a ton of fun, but you're working really hard. Doesn't mean you have to not do it. It just is a stressor. Where was I? Unproductive stressors are things like not eating enough consistently and causing, you know, physical stress, ignoring your hunger cues, experiencing grief, losing a baby, finding out you have an illness, finding out a loved one has an illness, anything that is negative. Okay, with me? Cool. All right. Now let's talk about the visual of allostatic load. Pretend you're sitting with a big bucket in your lap, okay? This bucket is your stress threshold, all right? And you can pour into it. Every time you have stress, there's a water hose and it's trickling into it, okay? So stress happens and you do a little squirt of water into the bucket. When you relieve stress through self-care, you get to pour a little bit out of your bucket, okay? So you want your bucket to not overflow. If your bucket does overflow, that's when you experience burnout, emotional breakdown, physical symptoms like maybe hair loss or acne, things like that. So you don't want your bucket to overflow. In order to function properly, we need to make sure that our pours are counteracted with our pour outs, okay? So the pours of water need to be counteracted by pouring out. So take me, for example. I will be candid and give my own self for you as an example. So in college, I was doing a really insane amount of things. I was training for the Boston Marathon. I was in chemistry classes. I was in charge of a lot of clubs. I was rock climbing after school. I was biking to school. We had people at our house all the time. There was a ton going on all the time in college, but my bucket at that time was larger. So your bucket doesn't stay the same size throughout your whole life. I had this really large bucket in college, and I don't know how, but I did. I was very blessed with that large bucket. So I could pour stress into my bucket very often and frequently, and I didn't take a ton of time to pour out. Because my bucket was so large, I got away with it. Now, to be completely honest, my bucket is probably a fourth of that size. So now, with work, with exercise that feels good to me, and with my relationships with my family, friends, John, and doing YouTube for fun on the side and little side hobbies, I'm completely full. Like, I would not want to add anything else to my bucket right now. I feel very satisfied in my spiritual life, in my relationships, but I feel that way because I'm pouring out by doing self-care often. Just wanted to let you know that your bucket fluctuates throughout your life. Also, huge thing is that your bucket is not the same size as your husband's, as your friend's, as your sister's, brother's, aunt's, uncle's. Like, every single person has a different size bucket. So maybe two people are training for a triathlon. Maybe that one person, person A, can run and swim and bike and do that 5 times a week. Maybe you can only do it 2 times a week. That's okay. Do it 2 times a week. That's okay. Maybe you can volunteer, also work and also maintain social relationships and also sleep a lot. Maybe your friend can't. Your bucket is never going to be the same as someone else's. So just don't compare yourself. Comparison is just so unproductive in so many ways, but when you're really thinking about the fact that your allostatic load is completely different than someone else's, it's a really easy way to kind of compartmentalize, like, I don't need to compare myself. So good reason to not is to think about your allostatic load. All right, now let's get to the fun part of how to reduce your allostatic load or pour out of your bucket so that you can stay more stress-free and maintain that allostasis. Okay, so my 5 easy tips are removing physical stress in your environment. So whether that means a 10-minute tidy in the morning and the evening, maybe that means that you decide to do 1 hour a week of decluttering the house. Maybe pick Saturday morning and you always declutter for 1 hour. Keeping your space clean, you guys, it's life changing. It's something that I've done ever since I was little and I didn't know why, but now I understand. It helps me kind of reduce my stress naturally. Creating routine in your day is number 2. So morning and evening routine, specifically 5 to 20 minutes is essential. A formula that I kind of like to follow, and I don't always do it. I'm not perfect, so a lot of times I don't get to it, but this is what works for me. It's starting with prayer, writing down 3 things I'm grateful for, 3 things that I have to do that day, 3 affirmations, and 3 people that I want to send love to. I found that formula from Sammy Clark on YouTube. And then talking with John, doing a little prayer with John, connecting with him in the morning. Then I'm going to go to work, then I'm gonna work out, then my day kind of changes throughout the week. But in the morning when I do those 3 things, that really sets me up for feeling grounded, feeling inspired, feeling loved, and feeling charged. In the evening, I like to unwind and ground again by maybe watching TV. Right now we're watching Survivor, it is so good. Maybe I'm reading, then I do a prayer and I talk to John in bed and we hang for a little bit. That is relaxing for me. Self-care is number 3. So self-care might mean getting your nails done, it might mean going on a walk, it might mean going on a hike, it might mean laying in bed and reading. Things, it's whatever helps you to relax. Maybe you're taking a bath. It could be anything, free, expensive, it's what you like. But that is a really great way to pour out your bucket. Moving in a fun way and sleeping more is number 4. So that is kind of a double there, but I combined those because they're kind of opposites and I think that they're both just as important as the other. So if you hate running in the winter, don't do it. I don't like to run in the winter as much, so I like to go to the gym more in the winter because that is what feels good to me. If I was running in the winter, that would just be more stress on my body and that's not gonna be pouring out, that's actually going to be pouring into my bucket. So also, maybe it's for you, it's just doing yoga. It doesn't have to be like crazy intense movement. It changes for me all the time and I listen to my body. That's something that I've gotten a lot better at this year and it has made a world of a difference in my stress. When you are more stressed, you just need more sleep because your body needs to process it. 8 hours is kind of like the gold standard, but maybe you need more, maybe you need less. I really think everyone needs at least 6 hours, whether you believe it or not. And then last one is so important, and it's just reframing how you think about stress. So maybe to you, you have to tell yourself that stress is just a challenge to master. This is a practice. I'm not amazing at this either, but when you take a step back, you say like, okay, here's a stressor, like what am I gonna do about it? I'm going to find a way to love this. And that is where you reframe your thoughts about stress, and it is so helpful. Last thing is a bonus tip, and it is smiling and laughing. And researchers at the University of Kansas found that smiling helps reduce the body's stress and can lower heart rate in tense situations. Another study linked smiling to lowered blood pressure, and another said that it leads to longevity. So easy little tips here. Recap, it's keep your environment clean, create routine, practice self-care, move your body and sleep more, reframe your thoughts about stress, and the bonus, smile. Thank you for listening to this quick little video. I hope you loved it. Hope you learned something. If you want to find out more wellness tips, keep on listening to these videos, like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.